Chronic conditions affect 40% of adult patients, and 24% of these patients have multiple chronic conditions. They are multimorbid. Management of chronic conditions is very complex. For example, patients with type 2 diabetes are expected to spend about 143 minutes every day in self-care. Hello, my name is Vieti Tran. I am an epidemiologist at Université de Paris and Assistance Publique Hospitals in Paris. And I'm delighted to present our work published in Mayo Clinic Proceedings entitled "Is My Patient Overwhelmed? Determining Thresholds for Acceptable Burden of Treatment Using Data from the COMPARE Cohort." For patients, the work of being a patient, that is management of drugs, organization of lab tests, visits, consultations, administrative work, can become a real burden of treatment. The objective of this work was to ascertain the highest burden of treatment beyond which patients with chronic conditions and multimorbidity consider their investment in time, efforts, energy, and money in care unsustainable over time. To answer this question, we analyzed data from the community of patients for research in France, COMPARE. COMPARE is an ongoing e-cohort of patients with chronic conditions with about 34,000 participants currently enrolled. We matched participants' answers to the treatment burden questionnaire, TBQ, a validated instrument to measure the burden of treatment in France, and those from a validated question, which was, coping with all health tests imposed on you can sometimes take a lot of time, effort, money, and sacrifice. Think about all the things you do to care for yourself. Do you think you could continue investing the same amount of time, energy, and money in your healthcare lifelong? To obtain representative estimates for the population of chronic patients in France, we weighted our data using sex-specific weights for age and educational level derived from the national census data of the French population. In total, 2,413 patients were enrolled in this study. Our results show that 38% of patients in our representative sample report that they found their burden of treatment unacceptable. Using our data, we were able to determine a cutoff for the treatment burden questionnaire, TBQ, which could discriminate patients with high burden of treatment, unacceptable burden of treatment, and others. And this cutoff was 59 points over a 150 point scale. In this study, we found that a large number of patients with chronic conditions in France report an unacceptable burden of treatment. We found this result across multiple conditions, treatments, and patients. This suggests that a considerable part of the burden of treatment is linked to the way we deliver care rather than specific patient treatment factors. For clinicians, our results show that it is really important to assess the burden of treatment for their patients. In previous studies, we showed that burden of treatment was associated with adherence and patient outcomes. For research, our research provides a cutoff to interpret burden of treatment scores, which could be used in trials using the TBQ as an outcome. Our research shows that a very high number of patients report unacceptable burden of treatment. This emphasizes the need for minimally disruptive medicine, a practice of medicine that seeks care that fits to patients' context.
We hope you found this presentation from the content of our website valuable. Our journal's mission is to promote the best interests of patients by advancing the knowledge and professionalism of the physician community. If you are interested in more information about us, our homepage is www.mayoclinicproceedings.org. There you'll find access to information for our social media content, such as additional videos on our YouTube channel or journal updates on Facebook. You can also follow us on Twitter. More information about healthcare at Mayo Clinic is available at www.mayoclinic.org. This video content is copyrighted by Mayo Foundation for Medical Education and Research.